Hello my friends and channel subscribers, Greg here from Brisbane, Australia with another unedited, uncut, no bull video. Today I would like to talk about meal replacement. And that's the interesting one. Many of you may know that I'm testing a lot of products and many products sent to me for review and opinion. And usually, or majority of my products that I tested, they are tested well. I recommend them, and it's really good to see companies are trying harder to promote and do better with what they manufacture. However, this product was a little bit different, and I've written already feedback to them, and they did not respond, so I'm not sure if they're changing anything. But to be honest, I was quite shocked how much, I wouldn't say lie, but deception going on from marketing perspective to what it is to be claimed that is not. And it's one of those videos that I basically say, hey, trust me, I'm not a doctor. It's not about medicine. It's about people trying harder to fix those health issues that they identify, and they're looking for, different ways of doing this. And meal replacements and shakes would be a very big industry. And you would think that companies are honest with us and ethical and do something good for us. So for example, when I received the packaging, you may see at the front, and I probably publish it below. And by the way, it's not me bashing the brand. This brand is well established, and I'm pretty sure they know what they're doing. So it says complete balanced nutrition. Sounds good, right? And then on the bottom it says 28 essentials, vitamins and minerals. You know what? Even better. Can you get 28 essentials, vitamins and minerals from your diet? Maybe yes, maybe no. But that packet claimed to have it all. And then it says it's a powder and you need to add it to the water. And voila, you've got healthy meal. The reason why I think they claim it's healthy, it says it's specifically formulated with essential fatty acids and low saturated fat. I'm not sure why low saturated fat is such a good thing, but it contains probiotics and shown to provide benefits to gut health, a key component of immune function. Isn't it great? That's actually, I'm reading everything that is in a big print. Then we've got here the whole list of vitamins and minerals that claim to be good for us. That's the list here. I don't want to read any of them, but you've got complex of vitamin A's, D's, E's, K's, C, at least 4 vitamin B's, which is really good. There's a list of minerals. It's amazing, isn't it? And I was about to try it, but then I thought, like, hey, I better pay attention to ingredients list. Because this is where the one place they literally cannot lie. What they can do is use fancy words instead of real name of ingredients, but they cannot lie, they cannot withhold ingredients from the ingredient list. It would be illegal, right? So I'm looking at the first ingredient, and it is hydrolyzed corn starch. Please tell me if it's healthy. First of all, corn, majority of corns we've got everywhere around us is GMO. It's genetically modified. It's designed to withstand all the diseases and propagate well. It's not designed to be nutritious. And if you notice, corn as you eat, it comes out the same way. We cannot digest most of it. And then they're taking the genetically modified corn, broken down to pieces, and they refined starch out of it. You know what, even if it's not harmful, and I doubt that way, it is refined carbohydrate. What it does when it comes to your body, it raises glucose in your bloodstream. Rising glucose in the bloodstream will spike insulin. Insulin will signal fat storage. So first of all, if using that shake as means to lose weight, it's already a wrong way with the first main ingredient. And by the way, first ingredient would be the ingredient that is most prevalent in this product. Let's keep going. It's actually getting quite more interesting. So the second biggest ingredient is vegetable oils. So what is the problem with vegetable oils? Well, vegetable oils are not natural oils. Even it sounds like a vegetable and we squeeze them, we get oils. It's not that way. It's usually flower oils, and they heated, they hydrogenated, they denatured, and they're becoming rancid. So what happens when they get into your body? They actually oxidizing everything around them and they become poison. So what's the problem with oxidation? Oxidation creates radical damage, and then there's a lot of debris left inside the body. But you know what? Let's take it from different perspective. Everyone heard of antioxidants and we're all keen on them. Why do we need antioxidants? Exactly, to prevent oxidation. Oxidation is not good when it leaves debris behind it. There's some oxidation in the body is alright, but not by hydrogenated oils. And by the way, when hydrogenated oils come into our body, many research proven that to get it out of the body, it takes 51 days. So if within 51 days you're consuming more hydrogenated oil, it will compound in your system as poison. So the hydrogenated oils, because they so harsh in the system, they would cause weight gain, probably gas, they would cause bloating, and in severe cases, skin rashes and irritation, and even asthma and cramping. So I would not think to use hydrogenated oils in your diet completely, in your any of your food. But you know what, if they claim it's a healthy supplement with healthy fats, I'm really wonder where they're getting them from, because hydrogenated oils, those are poisonous fats. The third biggest ingredient here is sucrose, and the fourth one is maltodextrin. Oh, look, to be honest, sucrose and maltodextrin are both very inflammatory components that proven by many researchers to get headache, dizziness, nausea, and other side effects. It's pretty bad stuff. And sucrose is basically will elevate your blood sugar. So I'm not sure how it's healthy when first three, four ingredients like that. Well, let's keep going. It's actually getting way more interesting. Milk protein concentrate. That is another very nasty product. And people are thinking like, oh yeah, it's taking good milk, they're concentrating it, so it's all good. I think there's a mistake between whey protein isolate and milk protein concentrate. So when you isolating whey from a milk, it's not 100% good, but it's actually isolating all the goodness of protein and giving to you. But when you got concentrate, that means you're taking all the nasty stuff, which is A1 casein, which is very inflammatory, and also all the lactose from milk and other nasties, you concentrate them and you deliver them. So many people will have an allergic reaction to normal milk, but when you concentrate all of that, it basically may get so many side effects, including allergic reactions and everything else. And of course, we have a lot of lactose, which is milk sugars. If you're not even allergic to that, it will raise your blood glucose, again, will trigger insulin response, and will store all of it as a fat deposits. So far, we're not losing weight here. We're consuming poison, but you know what? Let's keep going. There's another product that's number five on the list, soy. I'm not sure how soy and healthy product could be put in one sentence, because all soy that we got in commercial world is genetically modified. But biggest problem with soy, doesn't matter in which form it comes in, whether it's a soy protein or soy drink or soy milk or any soy sauce, soy is phytoestrogen. So we got, for simplicity of the explanation, we got good estrogen that any woman and even man needs, and we got phytoestrogens that basically counteract the good estrogen. That's the soy that will come here, will come with phytoestrogen, which is would be mood swings and and side effects like bloating and nausea and all of that. That's for women. For men, it's getting even worse. Estrogen in men's body would counteract testosterone, and basically it may turn all men's function to almost zero. It's pretty nasty what it is. So to be honest, I'm just looking at what claimed to be and what I'm reading from ingredients. I'm not sure where health benefits will come from, but you know what, that product as a meal replacement will give you a couple of things. First, I can guarantee you will be cravings. The reason is that because you consume it as a meal, it will satisfy you. There's a lot of dopamine receptors will be triggered by sugars and other genetically modified things. So you get pleasure by drinking it. There's a lot of yummy taste in it, but it will spike your insulin. And when insulin brings all the glucose down to normal levels, which basically very quick, you'll be hungry again. So you consume all your calories, you didn't get much, and you'll get hungry. So cravings guaranteed in this package. The second one is what they call bloat city. It will bloat you like no tomorrow. Every single ingredient in the first six main ingredients is inflammatory. It will get to your gut, it will inflame it and kill most of the good gut bacteria. I would not even think taking it. And it will result in some sort of ill feeling. You know how you're not well, but you cannot describe it? It will. If someone's sensitive to any of those ingredients, it definitely would deliver stomach cramps. And I don't even want to try it because stomach cramps is something that you don't want to, you know, you don't want to experience. And mood swings, soy, phytoestrogen, very, very bad thing. So what we can take from here, how we can, you know, improve on things. So first of all, I'm not bashing any protein shakes. Some of them have place. But what is important to read the label? You cannot trust any commercial spill on the front of the package. And again, I'm not bashing the brand, but I'm just quite appalled how they claim it's to be healthy while it's not. So when you read label, you can see clearly what it's made of. And the rule of thumb is least ingredient list will create better products. So for example, whey protein isolate or WPI should have only one ingredient, whey protein isolate. If it's flavored, it may have another two or three, which will be flavors and stabilizers, but they're not all bad. Just watch for those sugar replacements. If you really like tasty, nutritious drink, buy whey protein isolate, add some sweeteners that proven to be not damaging your gut gut bacteria, and here you go, you've got really good drink. But you know what, don't trust any claims. That's the point of this video. You cannot trust any claims. And again, if you would like food replacement, first of all, why protein shakes are so popular? Because the protein is very expensive for your body. It takes 8 units of energy to break 1 unit of protein in the body. And it's not all good story, but if your diet consists mostly of healthy fats and proteins, you won't gain weight. That's the biggest point of the story, but none of that stuff will help you to lose weight. So I'll put down in the description the proteins that I believe are great that you can get in Australia. I would not recommend whey protein isolate because again, it's derived from milk. If you can afford, buy yourself 100% non-genetically modified pea protein. I put one in the description below. If you like your whey isolates, I put pretty good whey protein isolate in the description. If it's not sweet enough, add some sweeteners. There's only three sweeteners that proven not to damage gut bacteria, which is erythritol, monk fruit, and stevia, down below in description as well. And just remember, not all shakes are the same. And if someone claim miracles on a shake, I would look at the ingredients straight away. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe, hit that like button, and hit notification bell so you won't miss any of my future videos. If this video you found interesting and you would like to know a little bit more or a little bit about different subjects, please let me know in down description below, and let's keep good stuff going. The whole idea of this channel to keep us healthy, keep us happy, and keep us away from doctor for long as possible. Thank you so much for watching.